शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनं भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणि विधाति पुरुण वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तरुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिरूपकारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवान्नमत्तोन्निति मे निश्चितामतिः। सुप्रसंगाद् अन्यत्रापि वाच्यवाचक भावस्थलाद् अन्यत्रापि भेदाभेद रूप तादात्म्य संबंध प्रदर्श्यते। तादात्म्य रूप संबंध इज भेद सहित अभेद एज पर पूर्व मीमांसक एंड दिस इज द संबंध विच इज देयर बिटवीन पद एंड पदार्थ दैट इज बिटवीन वाचक एंड वाच्य वाचक पदार्थ एंड वाचक पद एंड वाच्य पदार्थ बिटवीन देम देयर इज अ तादात्म्य संबंध विच इज भेद सहित अभेद। नाउ incidentally other places where such tadatmya rupa sambandha is there that is showcased here in the moola rupa rasa gandhadaya gunaha tadashraya bhutam dravyam guni so dravya has guna therefore dravya is called as guni what are these gunas rupa rasa gandha ityadi shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha those are the gunas अनेक समवेतः धर्मः जातिः। नाउ दिस इज व्हाट नैयायिकास डेफिनेशन इज ऑफ ईच ऑफ दिस जनरली इट इज एक्सप्लेन अनेक समवेत धर्मः जातिः। जाति इज अ ग्रुप और स्पीशीज अ क्लास और स्पीशीज ऑफ सिमिलर मेंबर्स देयर बाय अनेक समवेतः धर्मः जातिः। बेसिकली धर्म इज जाति एंड दैट इज अ क्लास अ स्पीशी अ ग्रुप ऑफ थिंग्स नाउ अनेक यथा सर्व ब्राह्मण शरीरेषु ब्राह्मणत्वम एकमेव वर्तते। सो हाउ डज जाति बिकम अ स्पीशीज हाउ डू यू गेट दैट काइंड ऑफ मीनिंग इट इज एक्सप्लेन यथा सर्व ब्राह्मण शरीरेषु ब्राह्मणत्वम एकमेव वर्तते। दिस ब्राह्मणत्वम इज वन इन ऑल ब्राह्मणास In all manushyas there is manushyatvam. In all pranis there is pranita or pranitvam. This tvatalau. Tasya bhava tvatalau. So that bhava pratyaya is added to explain that dharma which is there across the board. Those members are put together in a group and that is called as a jati. तथा सर्व पुरुषेषु एकं पुरुषत्वं सर्व घटेषु एकं घटत्वं च वर्तते। इन ऑल घटास देयर इज वन घटत्व इन ऑल पुरुषास देयर इज वन पुरुषत्वं लोके ब्राह्मणत्व पुरुषत्वादिकं यस्य उच्यते तस्मिन् ब्राह्मणादि शरीरे एव ब्राह्मणत्वादि जातिर् वर्तते। सो इफ यू आस्क वेयर इज दिस ब्राह्मणत्व जाति इट इज ओनली इन ब्राह्मणा वेयर इज दिस पारुष्यम और पुरुषत्वम इट इज ओनली इन पुरुषास वेयर इज दिस घटत्वम ओनली इन घटास बट ऑल घटास ऑल पुरुषास ऑल ब्राह्मणास देयर बाय ब्राह्मणत्वम बिकम्स अ जाति घटत्वम बिकम्स अ जाति पुरुषत्वम बिकम्स अ जाति ब्राह्मणत्वादि जात्याश्रयभूतम ब्राह्मणादि शरीरम व्यक्तिरित्युच्यते। नाउ दिस इंडिविजुअल मेंबर्स आर कॉल्ड एज व्यक्तिस सो वन ब्राह्मण इज अ व्यक्ति ऑफ द ब्राह्मणत्व जाति वन घटा इज a member vyakti of the ghatatva jati. One purusha is the member or vyakti of the purushatva jati. This is how jati and vyakti relation is there. And guna guni sambandha, jati vyakti sambandha. Further, gamana agamana adikam kriya ityuchyate. What is a kriya? Going, arriving back, all these are kriyas. Upward movement, downward movement, all these are gati kriya. And there are so many other kriyas. So gamana agamana adikam kriya iti uchyate. Tadvan kriyashrayaha karta iti cha uchyate. Now karta is tadvan, kriyavan. Kriyavan karta. Akarta cannot have any kriya. Akarta atma cannot have any kriya. But when you say, you know, somebody is doing something, that person undergoes some change. That is a karta. Kriya ashraya. So kriya is in this karta. He is the ashraya of that kriya. Kriya yaha ashraya tadvan kriyavan bhavati saha karta. Etavatam padarthanam tadatya sambandho vartata itti jnyatva karya karana rupam vastu guna gunyadishu yojayet. So these padarthas which are being discussed now here, they have tadatya sambandha. Iti jnyatva, once you know that, having known that karya karana rupam vastu guna gunyadishu yojayet, then you have to apply the same thing across guna guna guni, then jati vyakti, and so on. Wherever Nayayika says there is a samavaya sambandha, which is a nitya sambandha, the Purva Mimamsaka says there is a tadatmya sambandha, which is bheda abheda together. Atra ayam abhiprayaha. Guna guninor iva karya karanayor api tadatmya sambandha asti. This tadatmya sambandha, bheda abheda rupa tadatmya sambandha is there between guna and guni. Karya karanayo, just like guna guni and jati vyakti have this tadatmya sambandha, similarly karya karana also have this tadatmya sambandha. Shruti says that karya is never different from karana. So karya is mithya, mithya, karana is satya. This is how we use the karya karana prakriya in Vedanta. Purva Mimamsaka says that karya and karana have a tadatmya sambandha, which is bheda abheda rupa. So he says karya is not atyanta bhinna from karana, it is not atyanta abhinna also. Similarly, guna guni and jati vyakti ityadi. Gunagunino parasparam tadatmyameva sambandha tatha jati vyaktyo kriya kriyavato kriya kriyavatoscha parasparam tadatmya sambandha eva. So kriya kriyavan, guna and guni, jati and vyakti, karya and karana have a tadatmya rupa sambandha, which is bheda abheda rupa. Evam karya karano rapi tadatmyameva sambandha, tadatmyam nama bheda sahita abheda. This has been explained earlier in the case of Purva Mimamsaka. Tadatmyam nama bheda sahita abheda. We have to look at the first tippan also. We'll look at it together. Tayor atyanta bhinnatvat upadana tayor atyanta bhinnatvat. Sorry, I missed one line. Nimitta karanasya karyasya cha parasparam bheda bheda rupa tadatmya sambandho nasti. The nimitta karana and karya. When we say karya karana have tadatmya sambandha, that is between the upadana karana and the karya. Nimitta karana and karya are different. Ghata and ghata, ghatakara are different. There is no tadatmya sambandha between them. Ghatakara does not consider himself as ghata. Whereas the mrit and ghata have tadatmya sambandha. Bheda sahita abheda. Why does bheda abheda rupa tadatmya sambandha does not exist? Why does it not exist between the nimitta karana and karya? तयोर अत्यंत भिन्नत्वात् बिकॉज़ दे आर अत्यंत भिन्न दे आर नॉट सेम उपादान कारण कार्योस्तु भेदाभेद रूप तादात्म्यमेव संबंधः. सो वी कम बैक टू द मूल लेट्स लुक एट द टिप्पण. सो इन द लास्ट पार्ट वी हैड सीन दिस व्याप्य एंड व्यापक. वी हैड सीन इन द केस ऑफ ओम तथैव ओम इति अक्षर रूपं पदमपि वाची वर्तते तदर्थभूतं परम ब्रह्म तु न वाची वर्तते. सो दिस वाक विच इज वाचक ओम एंड परब्रह्म विच इज वाच्य पदार्थ बिटवीन ओम वाचक पद एंड ब्रह्म विच इज वाच्य पदार्थ व्हाट इज द संबंध. देर इज व्यापकत्वम देर एंड व्याप्यत्वम दैट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड हियर एज ब्रह्मणो व्यापकत्वेन वाची तदभावेपि ब्रह्मणि वाक् प्रतिष्ठिता भवति न तु वाची ब्रह्म देर बाय व्यापकत्वम ब्रह्म इज व्यापक देर बाय ब्रह्मणि एव वाक् प्रतिष्ठिता भवति. सो दैट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द टिप्पण एलाबोरेटेड इन द टिप्पण एज स्वल्प देशवर्ती व्याप्यम इत्युच्यते अधिक देशवर्ती व्यापकम इति च. What pervades more is called as vyapaka. What pervades in a lesser area is called as vyapya. Tatha hi, an example is given. Swalpa desha varti ghataha vyapyaha. Adhika desha vartitvad akasho vyapakaha. You look at this ghatakasha. This ghatakasha is not only within akasha. It is also outside akasha. It is also where there is the boundary of the ghata. The body of the ghata. So akasha is vyapaka tattva whereas ghata is vyapya. Vyapyam vyapake antar bhavati. This vyapya ghata, where is ghata? Ghata is in akasha. Akasha cannot be limited in ghata. Although we say ghata akasha, akasha is not limited by the ghata. So even if we say akasha is contained in the ghata, akasha is not really contained in the ghata. Akasha preceded the ghata and when the ghata was being made, that time the akasha was there within and outside. As and when the boundary was built, it was there in the place of the boundary also of the ghata. Therefore akasha is not contained, ghata is contained in akasha. सो अधिक देश वर्तित्वाद आकाश व्यापक व्याप्यम व्यापके अंतर्भवति व्यापकं तु व्याप्याद् बहिरपि वर्तते. आकाश इज देयर आउटसाइड घटा आल्सो बट घटा इज कंटेन्ड इन आकाश. घटा हा आकाशे अंतर्भवति आकाशस्तु घटादिभ्यो बहिरपि वर्तते तथा वा ब्रह्मापेक्षया अल्पदेश वर्तित्वेन व्याप्यत्वाद् ब्रह्मणि अंतर्भवति. सो वाक इज व्याप्य ओंकार इज व्याप्य इन द मूल ओंकार इज वाक और वाचक ब्रह्मापेक्षा अल्पदेश वर्तित्वेन ब्रह्म इज एवरीवेयर ऑल परवेसिव वेर एज ओंकार वाक इज ओनली वेर इट इज अटर्ड देयर बाय व्याप्यत्वात् ब्रह्मणि अंतर्भवति. ब्रह्म तु वागाद्यपेक्षया अधिकदेश वर्तित्वेन व्यापकत्वात् वागादिभ्यो बहिरपि वर्तते. Whereas this Vachya Brahma is Vyapaka and being Vyapaka, it is outside the Vyapya Omkara Vak also. Then in today's Patha we looked at the Tippana which is Tadatmyam. So we are looking at the Tippana now for Tadatmyam. What does it say? Tadatmyam Nama Bheda Sahita Abheda. गुणगुणिनोः जातिव्यक्त्योः क्रियाक्रियावतोः कार्यकारणयोश्च इति चतुर्षु स्थलेषु भट्टवद् वेदान्त्यपि तादात्म्यसम्बन्धम् अङ्गीकरोति. सो वी आल्सो से दैट अनलाइक नैयायिकास् और वैशेषिकास् अनलाइक तार्किकास् वी से दैट द संबंध बिटवीन गुणगुणी जाति व्यक्ति क्रिया क्रियावान एंड कार्य कारण इज तादात्म्य संबंध. दिस इज समथिंग दैट वी एग्री विथ द ओपिनियन ऑफ पूर्व मीमांसका. हाउएवर पूर्व मीमांसका सेज द तादात्म्य संबंध इज भेद सहित अभेद. वी हैव डिफरेंसेस देयर although we call it tadatmya sambandha, it is not the tadatmya sambandha of the purva mimamsaka, whereas we outright reject the idea of the nayayika as to there being samavaya sambandha between them. So we have seen this. Anyway, tippanakara wants to bring in more elaboration. Vedantya abhimata tadatmya sambandha lakshanam bhatta abhimata tadatmya lakshanad bhinnam eva. There is a difference between the पूर्व एंड उत्तर मीमांसका डेफिनेशन ऑफ तादात्म्य संबंध. चतुर्षु स्थलेषु नैयायिकः समवायाख्यं नित्य संबंधं ब्रूवते. दिस वी सॉ. ओके देयर इज दैट्स द टिप्पणम. एंड ऑफ द टिप्पणम. आई थॉट इट वाज अ लॉन्गर टिप्पणम. मे बी आई गॉट कंफ्यूज्ड विद इट. ओके सो नैयायिका से दैट देयर इज अ समवाख्य समवाय आख्य संबंध कॉल्ड अ समवाय which is a nitya sambandha between these four pairs, whereas mimamsaka says it's tadatmya sambandha which is different from vedantins tadatmya sambandha. Okay, maybe there was an earlier tippana left. I'm not sure. I thought there was a longer tippana. Okay, avarakshane, we have done this. Moving on, in the moola ghatasya nimitta karanam kulala dandadikam. So what is the nimitta karana in the case of ghata? It is the potter, the pot maker, the stick used to rotate the wheel, the chakra ityadi, all these are nimitta karanas. Nimitta karana also called as sahakari. The other karanas are also called as sahakari karanas at times. So kulala dandadikam are different from the karya ghata, whereas upadana karana mrut and ghata have तादात्म्य संबंध और समवाय संबंध और वेदांतीज तादात्म्य संबंध विच इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम भेद सहित अभेद तादात्म्य संबंध ऑफ दी पूर्व मीमांसक. तस्य घटाधिकारेण सह अत्यंत भेद एव अस्ति. हाउएवर दिस निमित्त कारण विच इज कुलाल, कुलाल एंड घटार अत्यंत भिन्न, दंड एंड घटार अत्यंत भिन्न, चक्र एंड घटार अत्यंत भिन्न, उपादान कारणभूत मृत्पिंड तत्कार्य भूत घटयोस्तु भेद सहित अभेद एव आस्ते. हाउएवर इफ यू लुक एट द उपादान कारण दे आर कंपैरेबल. आई मीन यू कैन एनालाइज इट एंड सी दैट देयर इज भेद सहित अभेद संबंध बिटवीन देम सेज द पूर्व मीमांसक. मृत्पिंडाद घटः यदि अत्यंत भिन्न स्यात् तर्हि अत्यंत भिन्न तैलादिवत् घटो अपि मृत्पिण्डान् न जायेत. हैड देयर बीन रियल डिफरेंस एंड कंप्लीट डिफरेंस बिटवीन द क्ले एंड पॉट, देन अदर एग्जांपल इज तैल. ऑयल इज आल्सो डिफरेंट फ्रॉम घटा. कैन यू क्रिएट घटा फ्रॉम ऑयल? यू कांट. सो देयर बाय अत्यंत भेदाय रिफ्यूटेड. उपादान कारणस्य स्वकारेण सह अत्यंत अभेद यदि स्यात् तदा नैव मृदः घट उत्पद्येत. सो मृदः घट न उत्पद्येत. फ्रॉम द मृत घट वुडंट हैव बीन प्रोड्यूस इफ देयर हैड बीन अत्यंत अभेद बिटवीन देम. जस्ट लाइक घट कैन नॉट कम आउट ऑफ घट, मृत कैन नॉट कम आउट ऑफ मृत. सिमिलरली यू कैन नॉट हैव अत्यंत अभेद बिटवीन दी कार्य एंड कारण एंड स्टिल हैव कार्य फ्रॉम दैट कारण. स्वस्वरूपादेव सोत्पत्यभावात्. यू कैन नॉट हैव समवन बॉर्न फ्रॉम वनसेल्फ और समथिंग बॉर्न फ्रॉम इटसेल्फ. तस्माद् उपादान कारणस्य स्वकारेण सह भेद सहित अभेदो अस्ति. अभेद सत्वाद् भेद पक्षोक्तो दोषः, भेद सत्वाद अभेद पक्षोक्तो दोषश्च न प्रसज्यते. नाउ दिस इज द रिपीटेशन एक्चुअली इफ यू लुक एट इन द केस ऑफ कार्य कारण भाव. दिस वी हैव सीन इन द केस ऑफ पद पदार्थ टेकिंग अग्नि एज एन एग्जांपल. सो आई विल जस्ट गिव इट अ लेग बाय. इत्थम उपादान कारणस्य स्वकारेण सह भेदाभेद रूप संबंधः युक्त्या सिद्ध्यति. देयर बाय this relation of bheda sahita abheda tadatmya rupa sambandha is established between the karya and its own karya, karana and its own karya. आपात प्रतीत्यापि उपादान कारणस्य कार्यस्य च भेदाभेदौ सिध्यतः इयम् मृत् अयम् घटः इति प्रतीत्या भेद सिध्यति विचार्यमाणे तु घटस्य अंतर्वहिश्च अंतरेण मृदं न अन्यत् प्रतीयते. एंड ही सेज अनुभव सिद्ध आल्सो इफ यू लुक एट योर ओन प्रतीति यू एनालाइज योर ओन एक्सपीरियंसेस व्हेन यू लुक एट घट Iyam mrit, this is clay. Iyam ghataha, when it is being made, you don't give money to buy clay, you give money to buy ghata. If you want clay, you will give money to buy clay, not ghata. If someone tells you, you wash your ghata or keep it immersed, break it, make it churna and then mix it with water, you will get clay. Obviously, you are not going to buy a pot if you want clay. And vice versa, the clay cannot be used as a pot, therefore there is atyanta, not atyanta, there is bheda. There is difference between ghata and mrut. The utility is different, applications are different, the pratiti is different. Obviously there is a difference between mrut and ghata. Nobody will, disagree with it. Anubhava siddha. And if you inquire, ghatasya antarvaiccha antaranam mridam na anyat pratiyate. But if you inquire into it, you don't see anything other than clay when you analyze the ghata. Therefore, abheda is also clear. Mrudeva pratiyate. Tasmat abheda siddhyati. So, antarena mrudam is mrudam antarena. Mrudam antarena nanyat pratiyate. You don't see anything other than mrut. Only mrut is seen when you analyze the ghata, therefore abheda is also established. Anena upadana karana karyoho bheda bheda rupa tadatmya sambandho asti. Therefore tadatmya sambandha of which type is there? Bheda sahita abheda, anubhava siddha. Tadvat guna gunino rapi bheda bheda sambandho asti. Ghata rupasya ghatat atyanta bhedo yadi syat tada ghatasya patena atyanta bheda sattva tatha patam अनाश्रित्य घट स्वातंत्रेण वर्तते तथा घट रूपम अपि घटम अनाश्रित्य स्वातंत्रेण्यैव तिष्ठेत. नाउ द गुण गुणी हैविंग तादात्म्य संबंध इज बीइंग एक्सप्लेन्ड एज भेद सहित अभेद संबंध. घट रूपस्य घटाद अत्यंत भेद यदि स्यात्. लेट्स से देयर इज अ ब्राउन कलर्ड पॉट. So that brown colored pot, the color brown and the pot itself had been completely different from each other. Then ghatasya patena atyanta bheda sattvat. Now this is logic, shushka tarka. If the color had been different, then patena atyanta bheda sattvat ghatasya. Ghata is different from pata also. If the ghata rupa is different from ghata, completely different, then I'll give you another completely different object. Can you create or bring some kind of a relation between them, whatever you think of? So this is the purvapaksha, who says tada ghatasya patena. Purvapaksha's objection, if it is there to ghata rupa being different from ghata atyanta bheda, then the Siddhanti as in Puravimamsaka here, not Siddhanti as in Vedantin, but the Puravimamsaka would say that Ghatasya Patena Atyanta Bheda Sattvat Yatha Patam Anashritya Ghata Svatantrena Vartate. To create a ghata, to produce a ghata, nobody needs a pata. No cloth is needed. So without any dependency on cloth, how this ghata comes about? Similarly, Tatha घट रूपम अपि घटम अनाश्रित्य स्वातंत्रेणेव तिष्ठेत. देन व्हाट वुड हैपन हियर? नॉट टू क्रिएट, नॉट टू प्रोड्यूस, बट वेर एवर देर इज अ पॉट, इज देर अ क्लॉथ एज वेल? नॉट नेसेसरी. सो दी घट स्वातंत्रेण वर्तते, Independently, the ghata exists without any dependency on whether or not expectancy on whether or not there is the cloth. So there is no dependency at all. There is no relation at all between them. Similarly, if there had been atyanta bheda between ghata rupa, meaning the color of the ghata and the ghata itself, then ghata rupa api. So tatha ghata rupam api ghatam anashritya svatantrena tishte. Then you would see this ghata, the color of the ghata without the ghata. So you would see the brown color separately from the ghata. But when you are cognizing the brown color, you are seeing the ghata also. So how does the pratiti of the ghata rupa take place? When you are seeing the ghata rupa, that time ghata will be seen. Without seeing the ghata, you cannot just see a floating color. Thereby, you cannot say there is atyanta bheda between ghata rupa and ghata. Guna guninor atyanta bheda yadi syat tadapi ghata rupam ghata shritam na syat. And if there had been no difference at all between ghata color and the ghata, then also you wouldn't have this pratiti. Ghata rupam ghata shritam na syat. The color wouldn't be in ghata. But the color is in ghata because there is no atyanta abheda. There is no atyanta bheda, there is no atyanta abheda, therefore there is bheda sahita abheda. Svasya eva svashrayatva sambhavat. You cannot rest upon yourself. A thing cannot rest unto itself. Similarly, if ghata rupa had been same as ghata, it couldn't rest in ghata. तस्माद् गुणगुणिनोरपि भेदाभेद रूप तादात्म्य संबंधो अस्ति इयमेव युक्तिः जाति व्यक्तयोः क्रिया क्रियावतोश्च भेदाभेद रूप तादात्म्य संबंधे अवगंतव्या. सो ही हैज गिवन टू एग्जांपल्स ऑफ गुण एंड कार्य कारण, कार्य कारण एंड गुणगुणी. दिस कैन बी एक्सटेंडेड टू जाति व्यक्ति एंड क्रिया क्रियावत. खंडनीय मतस्य अनेक युक्ति भी प्रसादने प्रयोजनाभावान्न युक्त्यंतराणि प्रदर्शन्ते. He says enough with this description. There is a different mata, we don't agree with it. So it's okay as long as you get what the Purvamimamsaka says and how we are different from them. You don't need to understand each and every detail and apply it to each and everything. There will be khandana done. So Bhattamata Khandanam, this is what is more interesting. How do we disagree and what do we agree with? That is more important. But to say that I disagree with you, you have to understand his viewpoint. You cannot just say that I don't agree with you if you don't understand what he is saying. Therefore, we have to understand the other's darshana to refute it. Otherwise, you cannot refute it. You cannot say this is also okay, that is also okay. Pooja Swamiji would say, ye bhi chalta hai, wo bhi chalta hai. Meaning, kuch nahi chalta hai. If you say this is also okay, that is also okay, Dvaiti is also right, Vishishta Advaitin is also right, and Purvamimamsaka is right, Sankhya, Yoga, Tarka, everything is acceptable. Oh, Buddha also said the same thing. If that is what you agree with, then you agree with nothing. Meaning, you don't have any understanding. That is the idea. So, we have to know the other's paksha to refute it and establish Siddhanta. This is Manana Shastra. After mananas alone you can have nishtha, only then there is even a possibility of mukti. So bhatta mata khandanam vachya vachakayor bheda bheda rupa tadatmyam asangatam iti nirupanam. You cannot have bheda sahita abheda sambandha between vachya and vachaka, between the pada and padartha. Ekasya vastunah एकस्मिन् अधिकरणे भेदाभेदयोर् उभयोः समानाधिकरणं विरुद्धम्. दिस इज प्लेन सिंपल कॉमन सेंस सेज दि सिद्धांति वेदांति टू पूर्वमीमांसका. यू कैनॉट हैव कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी थिंग्स इन द सेम लोकस. यू कैनॉट से इट इज देयर एंड इट इज नॉट देयर, मीनिंग भेद एंड अभेद. यू कैनॉट से दे आर सेम एज वेल एज डिफरेंट. That is why the Uttar Mimamsaka takes to the expression as I can't tell you. If you so Dvaitins ask the Purva Mimamsakas say tar tadatmya sambandha. Now the Dvaitins ask, what do you talk about it? to this Siddhantin. What do you talk about this Sambandha? We say it is Sadatmya Sambandha, all right, but we can't tell you as to whether it is Bheda or Abheda. Because it is not Bheda, it is not Abheda. Then is it together? It cannot be together. Common sense, you cannot have Bheda and Abheda together. So we say it is not possible. No explanation is needed. What has Purva Mimamsaka established? He says, as per him, Bheda Abheda is established. He used the example and then he says, Bheda Abheda Rupa Sambandha Yuktya Siddhyati. Yuktya na siddhati. He has taken, what is the yukti here? It is the yukti taken as individual with Bheda and individual with Abheda. He has said that Bheda is not there, Abheda is not there. Then he says Bheda is there, Abheda is there. Thereby, on one hand he has said Bheda is there. On other hand he has said Bheda is not there. Then he has taken the Abheda. He has explained Abheda is there, Abheda is not there. If you look at it, what he is saying is really anirvachaniya. Categorically cannot be said. From a perspective it appears as there is Bheda. From the perspective, from another perspective, there is appears as there is no Bheda. Similarly, from one perspective it looks as there is Abheda. From another looks like there is no Abheda. Thereby, what can you say? You cannot put them together and say that there is Bheda as well as Abheda. Yuktya na siddhyati really. Individually explaining Bheda and Abheda, or inquiring and analyzing Bheda and Abheda independently, then clubbing them together and saying that by Yuktya it is established, by Yukti it is established, is not right. In fact, by Yukti nothing can be established here. Therefore, you say that Yukti falls short in this analysis. All we can say is that it is different from Bheda, different from Abheda. You cannot say it as Bheda and Abheda together. Therefore, Yuktya Siddhyati itself is Asiddha. Thereby, in the Khandana, what do we say? Ekasya Vastuna Ekasmin Adhikarane Bheda Abhedayur Ubhayo Samana Adhikaranyam Viruddham. In the same Adhikarana, you cannot have Bheda and Abheda. There cannot be continuous together Yugapat. There cannot be Bheda and Abheda in the same Adhikarana. So in the same locus you cannot have that. Tasmat Stala Chatushtayepi Bheda Bheda Rupa Tadatmyam Yaduktam Tat Sakalam Viruddham Iti Yuktimanto Vadanti. One who has capacity to think to conclusion will say that there is contradiction. Katraim Avipraya. What is the idea? Ekasmin Ghate Swabhedasya Anyavastu Bhedasya Cha Samanadikaranam Yadyapyasti Tathapi Yasya Bhedosti Tasya Bhedaha Tatranasti. If the Purva Mimamsaka says, I also have Yukti, he says, you are using Tarka, I am also using Tarka. Look at what Tarkika says. Tarkika say that Ghata is not Pata. Pata is not Ghata. Now, if you look at any Ghata, does Ghata have Ghatatvam? So, in the Adhikarana Ghata, there is Ghatatvam. So, Ghatatva Jati is there. So, Ekasmin Ghate Swa Abhedasya Anyavastu Bhedasya Cha Swa Abhedasya. That Ghata has Ghatatva Jati, so it is not different from Ghata, it is Ghata. Is it a Pata though? No, it has Apatatvam. Does not have Patatvam. So there is no Patatvam there. It is not same as Ghata. So although it is not same as Pata, it is Ghata. So Ghata has Ghatatvam, but it has Pata Bhinnatvam also. Is it Bhinna from Pata? Yes, every Ghata is Bhinna from Pata. Then Ghata has Ghatatva as well as Pata Bhinnatvam. So what is it being said? Swa Abhedasya. Different from Ghata or not? No. A Ghata is not different from any ghata ghata, it is different from another ghata, but it's by itself it has abheda, meaning ghatatva is there. Then anya vastu bheda, or if you take ghata itself, it is same as itself and it is different from the other. So so abheda is there and anya vastu bheda is there. Either you compare across ghatas or you compare across ghata and pata, both are okay. Just to understand what is being said in the same adhikarana, what can be there. Or in the case of buddhi, we had seen earlier, as you can have paroksha jnana and aparoksha jnana of different things together. You cannot have atma parokshataya known and aparokshataya also known in the same adhikarana. You cannot have. What can you have? You can have paroksha jnana of aikya, brahmatma, and you can have aparoksha jnana of sharira, that I am brahmana, kshatriya, ityadi, I am manushya, I am a man, a woman. These ideas can be there. Whatever idea you have, that notion is aparoksha. Aparoksha jnana of the sharira is there in the same adhikarana where there is paroksha jnana of aikya after listening to something like tattvamasi. How? We do not understand, but we know that Shastra says that time paroksha jnana of the Vedanta Mahavakya plus aparoksha jnana of the sharira is in the same adhikarana. Similarly here, swabhedasya anyavastu bhedasya cha samana adhikaranim yadyapi asti ghate. In the ghata it is there. They are not contradictory though. Why? Because swa abheda and anya bheda can be together. Tathapi yasya abheda asti tasyeva bheda tatra nasti. However, you cannot say ghatatva and aghatatva are together, or swa abheda and anya abheda are together. Yasya bheda asti swa bheda and स्वभेद रादर स्वभेद एंड स्वभेद घट भिन्न एंड घट अभिन्न दिस घटा इज घट भिन्न एंड घट अभिन्न दैट कैन नॉट बी सेड अबाउट द घटा इट कैन नॉट बी टुगेदर इन 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 इटसेल्फ सो घटत्व एंड अघटत्व कैन नॉट बी देयर इन द सेम अधिकरण ऑफ घटा तस्य भेदा यस्य भेदा अस्ति तस्यैव अभेदः नास्ति इति अभिप्रायेण एकस्य वस्तुना भेदाभेदौ विरुद्धौ इत्युच्यते. Therefore it is said that you cannot have भेद एंड अभेद टुगेदर एंड thereby भेद सहित अभेद इटसेल्फ इज एन इम्पॉसिबिलिटी युक्त्या न सिद्ध्यति. एकस्य घटस्य स्वस्मिन् अभेदः परस्मिन् भेदश्च यद्यपि अस्ति तथापि यत्र अभेदोऽस्ति तत्र नास्ति भेदः. It is explained in another way. There is ghata 1 and ghata 2. So, swasmin, in ghata 1, it has ghata 1 abheda. Parasmin bhedaha. In the other ghata, there is ghata 1 bheda, whereas in ghata 1, there is ghata 1 abheda. So, ghata 1 will have घटा वन अभेद एंड घटा टू विल हैव घटा वन भेद. दे आर इन डिफरेंट अधिकरण. सो दिस भेद एंड अभेद कैन बी देयर अक्रॉस अधिकरण सेम वस्तु. सो लेट्स से नील घटा एंड पीत घटा. A better way to explain it, instead of ghata 1 and ghata 2, can't make a Sanskrit sentence or words out of it. Let's say there is a neela ghata and peeta ghata. Neela ghata and peeta ghata are different. Both have ghatatva jati resting in themselves. In different adhikarana, there is ghatatva jati. So ghatatva jati can be there in peeta ghata also and neela ghata also. Now this neela ghata has neela ghata abhinnatvam. being Nilaghata itself, Nilaghata has Nilaghata Abhinnatvam. It cannot have, meaning Nilaghata Abheda is there in Nilaghata. In the earlier way of explanation, what has been said? This Nilaghata has Nilaghata Abheda and Pitaghata Bheda in the same Adhikarana Nilaghata. So Nilaghate Nilaghata Abhedatvam Asti Tathacha Pitaghata Bhedatvam Asti. These can remain in the same Adhikarana because they are different. You cannot say Nilaghata Bhedatvam and Nilaghata Abhedatvam, both are there in Nilaghata. That is not possible. Contradiction. Now, another way it is explained is, how can you have these two resting in Adhikarana only when the Adhikaranas are different? So, Swasmin Abheda Parasmin Bhedascha Yadyapi Asti. So, in Nilaghata and Pitaghata, Nilaghata has Swasmin Abheda, meaning it has Nilaghata Abhinnatvam, Nilaghata Abhedatvam in Nilaghata. But Nilaghata Bhedatvam or Nilaghata Bhinnatvam is there in Pitaghata. So, Parasmin Pitaghate. So, if you understand this as Swasmin Abhedaha, meaning Swasmin Nilaghate Abhedaha Parasmin Pitaghate Bhedascha Yadyapi Asti Tathapi Yatra Abhedo Asti Tatra Nasti Bhedaha. You don't have Nilaghata Bhedatvam in the same locus of Nilaghata where there is Nilaghata Abhedatvam. Yatra Bhedo Asti Tatra Nasti Abheda. And if you inquire into the Pitaghata, Yatra Pitaghate Bheda Asti, Yatra Pitaghate Nila Bhedatvam Asti, Nila Bhinnatvam, Tatra Nasti Abheda, Tatra Nila Ghata Abheda, or Nila Ghata Abhinnatvam Nasti. Iti Abhiprayena Ekasya Vastunaha Bheda Bhedau Ekasmin Adhikarane Viruddhau Ityuchyate. That is the Viruddhatvam, which is right in your face, but it has to be explained in a Tarkika's way for the Puro Mimamsaka to see the point. Kincha, why? Because he has said that Bheda Sahita Abheda Siddhyati. Na Siddhyati. We have to explain how it is Siddha. He has just jumped to conclusion, Yuktya Na Siddhyati. If you apply Yukti, it has to be done stepwise, therefore, so much of detail has been given to refute the Purva Mimamsaka on his own ground. Using the same yukti that he is using, we are using that and surgically removing his misunderstanding. Kincha bheda bhedau parasparam virodhinau. There is virodha between bheda and abheda. They cannot be in the same adhikarana. Ekasmin vastuni yasya bheda asti, tasya abheda asti, tasya bhedascha viruddha eva. It is very clear. Tasmat वाच्यवाचक्योः गुणगुणिनोः जातिव्यक्त्योः क्रियाक्रियावतोः उपादानकारण तत्कार्योश्च भेदाभेदरूपतादात्म्यसम्बन्धाभ्युपगमः असंगत एव. सिंस जनरली देर के नॉट बी, आई मीन एज अ जनरल विद एन एग्जांपल, एज अ जनरली इट हैज बीन शोन दैट देर के नॉट बी भेद एंड अभेद टुगेदर. देर फोर वेदर यू से इट इज बिटवीन गुण एंड गुणी, Vachya and Vachaka, Guna and Guni, Jati and Vyakti, or Kriya and Kriyavat, you cannot have, or Upadana, Karana and Tatkarya, there cannot be Bheda Sahita Abheda. That kind of Tadatma Sambandha cannot be there. Yaduktam, Vachaka Shabdo, Vachi Vartate, Vachyo Artho, Bahir Vartate, Iti, Vachya Vachaka, or Bhedo, Loka Prasiddha, Shrutav, Omkara Rupa Aksharam, Param Brahma Ityuktatvat, अभेदश्च सिद्धा इति वाच्यवाचकयोर् भेदाभेदौ प्रमाण सिद्धौ इति. नाउ ही इज टेकिंग दी प्रमाण विच ही हैज गिवन. मांडुक्य उपनिषद सेज दैट ओंकार रूप अक्षर पद वाचक एंड ब्रह्म विच इज ऑल परवेसिव व्यापक पदार्थ वाच्य हैव this aikya or tadatmya sambandha abheda siddha and it is loka prasiddha also. Therefore, vachya vachakyo bhedaha by vyapakatvam, you see, vachyaha artha bahi vartate and therefore vachaka shabda vachi vartate. This is loka prasiddha, therefore bhedaha loka prasiddha and shruti pramana says there is no difference. So, bheda is established by loka prasiddhi, anubhava siddha, between vachya and vachaka. Nobody says that. What I am saying itself is the padartha. So, vak and padartha, pada and padartha have a difference, is well known to everyone, need not be explained. Whereas, the abheda is established by shruti. Shruti tells you something that you don't know. Therefore, Mandukya Upanishad saying that vachya vachakyur abhedaha, that is a pramana, thereby bheda sahita abheda is established between vachya and vachaka, putting the loka prasiddha anubhava and pramana of the shruti together, you get bheda sahita abheda. This is what was said by the purva pakshi, gathering that atra uchyate. Tasmin vishe uchyate atra or tatra. Because he has brought back that idea, therefore he says asmin vishe uchyate atra uchyate pranava rupasya omkarakshrasya parabrahmanascha abhedo vede kathitah natu tasya vedasya vachya vachakyor abhede tatparyam. What is being said by this Mandukya Upanishad and other Upanishad mantras is pranava omkara is an akshara. Tasya aksharasya omkarasya pranava rupasya omkarasya parabrahmanascha abheda vede kathitah. Parabrahma and omkara akshara, which is pranava rupa, there is a difference. There is a non-difference, abheda. So there is an abheda. Sorry for this making mistakes in translating that as to difference and non-difference. So abheda, I'll stick to abheda. So abheda kathitaha vede. However, vachya and vachaka having abheda is not the tatparya there. Pranava rupa omkara and parabrahma have abheda. How do you jump to vachya and vachaka being abhinna? This is the Siddhanti asking the Purva Pakshi in order to answer his objection, or he is raising an objection and thereby countering his viewpoint. He says Mandukya mantra is a pramana for abheda between vachya and vachaka. We say it is not. It is pramana only in what has been said. What has been said? It is said that omkara akshara is parabrahma. Om iti brahma. How do you jump to vachya and vachaka abheda from that? Tasya gudam tatparyam antaramasti. So tatparyantaramasti. Tasya gudam tatparyantaramasti. There is a hidden meaning there which you have not analyzed, says the Vedantin to Purva Mimamsaka. Yatra yatra omityaksharam brahma iti kathyate, tatra tatra omityaksharam parambrahma rupena upasyam. It has tatparya in upasana, not in just saying that vachya and vachaka are abhinna. There is a tatparya of upasana. Don't just assume that since om is brahma, therefore every pada and padartha will have abheda. It has no laukika prayojana. What are you going to get if you say agni pada and agni padartha are non-different? You, the Purva Mimamsaka, has the entire life spent, has his entire life spent in karaka bheda. Each karaka is different from another karaka. Each of the pada is different from padartha. When you utter a mantra, you have to use the dravya and actually offer. You cannot say, pushpam samarpayami and not give the pushpa. You cannot say johomi and not offer the ahuti. You have to offer the ahuti. So how can you say pada and padartha are abhinna when in your behavior they are bhinna? So this bheda sahita abheda won't work because of contradiction. Now the pramana that you are using that is also incorrect because the pramana has not been understood for you. Where is it pramana? In laukika vishaya, shruti is not pramana. And you are applying it to laukika vishaya as to pada and padartha have bheda sahita, bheda tadatme sambandha because shruti says so. It won't work. Shruti says omkara, which is not known otherwise in loka, as the name of Ishvara Parabrahma. Now you have to do upasana on that omkara as Parabrahma. That is the tatparya. Om ityaksharam parabrahma rupena upasyam ityarthe vakyasya tatparyam natu parabrahmanah om ityaksharasya cha bhedabhave. It is not saying abheda between the two. That's a general statement, but that general statement has to be analyzed. So om iti brahma mean om iti brahma upasyam. Idam tu tatparyam bhattaha na veda. This is something that Bhattas did not understand, and therefore they assume that it is bheda sahita abheda between om and parabrahma and extend it to vachya and vachaka. Very interesting. This is something that you don't see anywhere else. Yatha vidhiyate tatha eva upasyasya swarupena bhavyam iti na niyamaha. Now if there is an objection by Purvamimamsaka that how can Shruti say you do upasana of Parabrahma using Omkara? So you say Omkara Shabda, I'll do upasana on Omkara. Again it is Shabda, Shabda Rupa, Shabdakara, it is not Rupakara. So let's differentiate that. It is not a symbol which is visual, it is a symbol which is heard. It is a sound symbol. So nobody should do upasana by drawing Omkara on a chart, or you know, they have pictures. Omkara should not be drawn, and nobody should do upasana on that. It is not valid at all. Sakapola kalpita. Om is an akshara. Akshara is not something that you write. Akshara is heard. So shabda, Omkara is shabda. Upasana should be on the shabda. It is settled. Visual is easy. You can keep your eyes open, or once you practice it, then you can have an image within. Having the, you know, Guru in the Antakkarana Vritti, having Ishvara or Ishta Devata in Antakkarana Vritti is visual dhyana. However, the dhyana prescribed here is on Omkara Shabda. It is settled. One has to bring the Shabda Vritti in the Antakkarana. One should not visualize. And then also there are details we have seen earlier in the 5th chapter. So akara, ukara, makara, what they mean, all this has been discussed in Mandukya Upanishad. Sannyasi has an adhikara in omkara upasana. Now pranav rupa upasana is a tatparya there, not abheda between the two, or bhedasya abhava between vachya and vachaka, or in the specific example also between omkara and parabrahma. If there is an objection to this by the Purvamimamsaka as to how can upasana be prescribed on something where there is no abheda, he says, how can you do upasana on omkara? If omkara is not parabrahma, how can you do upasana on omkara as parabrahma? So there should be bhedasya abhava, bheda bhava between omkara and parabrahma. That should be the tatparya as well. Let it be upasana as a tatparya, let upasana be tatparya, but upasana has been prescribed by Shruti, therefore why not we conclude that there is abheda between the two? To this the answer is yatha vidhiyate tathaya upasasya swarupena bhavyam iti na niyamah. You need not have that dhyana, in the dhyana or upasana, you need not have the same bhavana the way it really is. Need not be so. Why? Shiva dhyana you do in Shivalinga. Shivalinga is not Shiva. You invoke Shiva in the Shivalinga. That is different from saying that Shivalinga and Shiva are abhinna. They are not same. So there is a difference. When you do the upasana is of the type as this Shivalinga which I have right here is Shiva. Similarly, Salagrama is Vishnu. You do Vishnu Dhyana. How Vishnu Dhyana? Vishnu has a form. Salagrama has no particular form. It is under Rupa, Andakara. So how can you have such Dhyana when there is Abheda? Similarly, you can have Dhyana, Upasana is possible on Parabrahma when you just have this Omkara Shabda in the Antakarana. किंतु वस्तुनः स्वरूपं विहाय रूपांतरेणापि वस्तु उपास्यते यथा सालग्रामस्य विष्णुरूपेण बाणस्य शिवरूपेण च उपासनं शास्त्रेण उपदिश्यते. सो वेदर यू टेक बाण एज शिव और विष्णु इज उपास्य विथ सालग्राम. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ सालग्राम यू डू ऑन दैट सेम सालग्राम यू हैव अध्यास, यू फोर्स एन अध्यास, यू इमेजिन Vishnu. Shastra talks about it. Upasanam shastrena upadishyate yatha tatra shankha chakra gadadyupeta chaturbhuja visishta murtir na salagrame asti. Salagrama does not have, andarupa salagrama does not have that kind of a form of Vishnu, chaturbhuja Vishnu ityadi, shankha chakra gadadhari. Nacha bane गंगालंकृत जटाजूट डमरू डमरूक चर्मक पालाद्युपेत. सो कपाल, सो दिस कपाल हियर. सो गंगा अलंकृत, शिवा इज गंगा अलंकृत, देन ही हैज जटा. सो जटाजूट डमरूक चर्म कपालादि उपेता शिवः भद्रामुद्रया शरणागतानां गुणत्रयातीत आत्मतत्वोपदेष्ट्री मूर्तिर् न अस्ति. सो बाणे नास्ति इन दि बाण व्हेन यू आर डूइंग ध्यान ऑफ शिव, दैट काइंड ऑफ शिव हैविंग अ भद्रमुद्रा प्रोटेक्टिंग ऑल दीस शरणागतास हु इज free from the three gunas, gunat gunatraya atita, that atma tattva upadeshta, atma which is free from gunatraya, Shiva himself is beyond the three gunas, but he has some rupa, that kind of rupa is not there in bana, but in this bana there is upasana prescribed. Kintu shastrajnya शिलादृष्टि परित्याग पूर्वकं सालग्रामे बाणे च क्रमेण विष्णुस्वरूपेण शिवस्वरूपेण च उपासनं क्रियते तस्माद् उपासनं नोपास्य स्वरूपाधीनं किंतु विध्यदीनं. उपासना हैज नथिंग टू डू विथ भेद और अभेद. देयर कैन बी भेद एंड अभेद ध्यान कैन बी प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बट स्टिल इट शुड बी डन, इट विल रिजल्ट टू फल बिकॉज श्रुति हैज अ विधि, सच अ विधि. But it does not establish abheda. Yatha shastram vidatte tatha upasitavyam. Kincha chandyogya upanishadi panchagni vidya prakrane dyuparjanya prithivi purusha yoshidrupaha panchaya padarthaha agnidrushtyo upasitavyaha. So there is panchagni vidya. In that Panchagni Vidya of Chandogya Upanishad for a Grahastha, some Upasana is prescribed there. So, five Padarthas are described and what kind of Dhyana should be done, restricted to a Grahastha. Shraddha Soma Vrishtyo Vrishtyantareta Rupaha Pancha Padartha Ahuti Rupena Upasaniya Iticha Shruti Rahu. So, all of these are treated as Ahutis. So there is an adhikarana in which ahuti is offered. What is an ahuti? Which is an adhikarana? They are not really so. There is no real ahuti. But ahuti is to be imagined in dhyana. During the kriya or otherwise also this panchagni vidya is taught in Chandogya Upanishad for a grahastha. So ahuti rupena upasaniyaha padartha. This pancha padartha which are द्युपर्जन्य पृथ्वी पुरुषयोषित एंड अग्नि दृष्ट्या उपासितव्यः, दे आर ऑल अग्नि अधिकरण. इन दोस काइंड ऑफ अग्निस विच यू इमेजिन, श्रद्धा सोम वृष्टि इत्यादि, दीज आर दी फाइव पदार्थास. So anyway, since we are looking at it, so Shraddha and then Soma. So when Shraddha is offered, Soma is born in the Adhikarana. So all these are due. So Shraddha is, since we are there, and we, let me just mention it. Shraddha is offered in due. Due is Swarga. So when Shraddha is an Ahuti imagined, in the Upasana, Shraddha is an Ahuti. That is Upasana offered into Agni, which is Swarga, or Swarga, which is seen as Agni. Then what comes out is Parjanya. Soma is offered in Parjanya. Then Vrishti is offered in Prithvi. Then Anna is offered in Purusha. Then Reta is offered in Yoshit. Yoshit is three. Priyata is Bija. So final Ahuti. So this is how the Jiva is born. So the entire journey of the Jiva is included in the Panchagni Vidya. How the Jiva comes from, you know, Swarga Ityadi, how he comes down in the form of, finally in the form of a crop which is eaten by a Purusha, and as the seed planted in the wife, and then a son or a daughter is born. So this is Panchagni Vidya. And then this is Upasana also. If you look at it, there is Shraddha is not really Ahuti. Due Swarga is not Agni. But still, Dhyana is prescribed by Chandogya. This is very well known to a Purva Mimamsaka. So we tell him, the way you know this already, similarly, Mandukya Upanishad talking about this, there an Upasana is being taught, whereby Abheda is not established. Thereby Shraddha as Agni, there is no Abheda between Shraddha and Agni. Due and Agni, Shraddha and Ahuti, there is no Abheda. Between due and Agni, there is no Abheda, just because Upasana is taught. Therefore, your objection or your question as to why can't we take it as literal is not valid, because you don't take it literal there also where you do this Upasana as a Grahastha, as a Purva Mimamsaka Vaidika. तत्र द्युलोकादयः न अग्नयः नापि श्रद्धादयः आहुतयः, किन्तु वेदाज्ञया द्युलोकादयः अग्नित्वेन श्रद्धादयश्च आहुतित्वेन उपास्यन्ते. एवमेव ओमित्यक्षरविषयक ब्रह्मोपासनम् उक्तम्. सो जस्ट लाइक यू टेक देम टू बी अग्नि व्हेन दे आर नॉट अग्नि. व्हाई? बिकॉज श्रुति सेज सो. एंड यू टेक ऑल ऑफ दोज विच आर प्रिस्क्राइब्ड एज आहुतिस इन द उपासना. You do Upasana like that, but you don't take them literally. Similarly, Om is also to be meditated upon as Parabrahma. There is no Abheda between them. Tatra Om ityaksharasya vastutah Brahma swarupatva bhavepi Brahma swarupatvena upasyatvam upapadyate. So it is tenable as an Upasana even if there is no Abheda between the two. Upasana vakye vastuna abhedo na apekshate. There is no expectancy at all in this Upasana to have Abheda between the Upasya Murti or Upasya Vastu. Kintu, so between them and the and whatever you are doing Upasana on. Kintu Bhinnam Vastu Abhinnataya Upasyate. It is really Bhinna, and that Bhinna Vastu is seen with Abhinnatvam. विचार्यमाणे ब्रह्मवाचकस्य ओंकारस्य स्ववाच्य ब्रह्मणा स अभेद युज्यते च. सो इफ यू इंक्वायर आल्सो व्हाट हैपेंस, ब्रह्मवाचकस्य ओंकारस्य स्ववाच्य ब्रह्मणा स अभेद युज्यते च. विचार्यमाणे कलशादि जडरूपार्थवाचकानां घटादिपदानां तु स्ववाच्य जडरूपार्थैर अभेदो न युज्यते एव. ही सेज इफ यू इंक्वायर इनटू इट इन द वे दैट यू नो an Advaitin would inquire into it. Once you start inquiring into Omkara as Vachaka and Brahma, which is Vachya. So Brahma Vachakasya Omkarasya. Omkara which stands for Brahma and Brahma which is revealed. That Brahma, if you inquire into in the Vedi Upanishad deals with it, not only as an upasana, but revealing the Aikya, then that is applicable only in the case of Brahma and Omkara. You cannot extend it. So, sa abheda yujyate cha vicharyamane vedantaritya. But if you look into kalasha roopa ghata and the pada ghata, kalashadi jadarupartha vachakanam ghatadi padanam tu so vachya jadarupartheir abhedo na yujyate eva. However, you use this inquiry and apply it to the pada and padartha, ghata and kalasha, it won't work. Tathapi sarvesham namarupanam brahmani kalpitatvat brahma sarvadishthanam bhavati omkaropi brahmano nama tasmad brahmani omkar kalpitah. So he says, now Vedantin says, how does this abheda really work when you inquire into it? It is not the way you think that ghata and ghata, ghatapada and ghatapadartha are abhinna. They are abhinna not the way you think, but if they are abhinna and they are abhinna as revealed by the Shastra, not in the way you think. The process of inquiry should be right to take away all the doubts. He says they become abhinna through Brahma. Akaro vai sarva vak. Omkara e Omkara stands for each and every nama. Therefore, every nama is included in Omkara. Omkara is Ishvara's nama. Therefore, every nama is included in Omkara. Now, on the other side, Padartha is Brahma. Brahma is Sarvadishthana Brahma. Sarvakaranana api karanam Brahma. That Karana Brahma includes every Padartha. Therefore, Omkara has all namas, all padas, and Brahma has all padarthas. Omkara is said to be one with Brahma, vicharyamane, which we saw in the first sentence. Thereby, all padarthas are included in all padas. Vaya Omkara, vaya Brahma. So, tatha sarvesham namarupanam brahmani kalpitatvat. And where is this namarupas imagined? Nama Omkara, which includes all padas, all namas, they are kalpita in Brahma, which is the real vastu, vasatiti vastu, which you call as padartha here. So all these padarthas have nama rupa, which are kalpita in the real padartha vastu Brahma. Tasmad tathapi sarvesham namarupanam brahmani kalpitatvat brahma sarvadishtanam bhavati omkaropi brahmana nama tasmad brahmani omkara kalpitaha. In Brahma, omkara is kalpita. That is the abheda there. Kalpitam vastvadishthana avyatiriktam adishthanatmakam eva bhavati. And we have seen many times as kalpita vastu is adishthana avyatirikta. It is never different from its adishthana. Nama rupa is mithya. Thereby, Aikya, Abheda, that you are insisting upon, we welcome the thought, but in the right manner. Not by saying Bheda Sahita Abheda. Bheda Sahita Abheda is ridiculous. We have pointed out that there is Virodha. But still there is Abheda. How? So, for Purvamimamsaka to understand, or Siddhantin or Vedantins wanting to be, those who want moksha, they should inquire in this manner. There is no bheda sahita bheda. There is abheda because there is kalpita bheda. Therefore, what is this bheda sahita abheda tadatmya of Purva Mimamsaka? It is virodhatva, impossible. Ashakya, it is ayukta. What is the tadatmya that we talk about? Kalpita bheda sahita vastava abhedaha. So if we have to extend upon Purva Mimamsaka's Bheda Sahita Abheda, we'll say Bheda Sahita Abheda as you understand is not possible. Kalpita Bheda Sahita Vastava Abheda is definitely possible. And that is this tadatmya sambandha of the Vedantin. Kalpitam vastu adhisthana avyatirktam adhisthanatmakam eva bhavati tasmat om ityaksharam brahmaeva ghatadi padanam tu jadarupa swartho nadhisthanam kintu sovachyehi sa ghatadi shabdaha brahmani kalpitaha. This case of omkara being kalpita in brahma can be extended to other padarthas only through omkara, because omkara stands for all names. You cannot apply it and say that ghata name is in ghata padartha. It is not. Nobody can understand it because it is not valid. The ghata name is in brahmadishthana ghata padartha via omkara, where the nama is kalpita. So omkara nama is kalpita, which has ghatapada kalpita in what? Brahma, which is the adhisthana, where adhisthana for what? Ghatapadartha. This is how you understand it, not as ghata and ghatapada are really having abheda. Because ghatadi padanam tu jadarupa swartaha na adhisthanam, there is no adhisthana. It is ghata pada does not have ghata jada padartha as adhisthana, but brahma is the adhisthana. Kintu sovachya isa ghatadi shabda brahmani kalpita tasmat brahma eva ghatadi padanam adhisthanam tasmat sarva karanatvena sarva adhisthanatvat sarva padanam brahma bhedo yujyate. Only by inquiring into brahma and omkara rightly you can land in brahma as adhisthana and kalpita nama rupa, whether it is omkara having everything else or all the nama rupas, now will fall into the adhisthana of brahma, thereby abheda can be established. Ghatadi padanam tu jada rupa svachesa abhedo na kenapi pramanena yujyate. There is absolutely no pramana for bheda. You have pramana in loka prasiddhi that he has mentioned here. Loka prasiddha, earlier he had mentioned that, which is being analyzed. So what was said? Yaduktam vachaka shabdoha vachi vartate vachya artha bahir vartate iti vachya vachakayor bheda loka prasiddha. Agree with that loka prasiddha and in vyavahara go with that, but then when you inquire into it, then abheda is pramana siddha, but Upanishad has to be, Upanishad mantra has to be inquired into, and thereby you can land on this aikya. Thereby tasmad I'm not sure what this is. Pramanena kenapi pramana tasmad I don't know bhatta, so sorry, there is a typo here. Actually it is bhatta, it is not dhru. So tasmad bhatta vimataha vachya vachakyor abheda naiva sambhavati. Therefore this vachya vachaka abheda is not established at all, let alone bheda sahita abheda, which builds upon this abheda. Abheda is not pramana siddha the way the bhatta say. Okay, we'll stop here. See in the next part. Sukarnityam swaprakasham vyapakam namarupya adhisthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyatva nirvana param sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak param tadeva annamattva nirdime nishchitamatihi tatsat. Any questions? Namaste.
Hari Om.